Muy importante, para la sesión de hoy vamos a ocupar una hoja de papel y un lápiz o una pluma o un plumón. Entonces, si no lo tienen, corran para conseguirlo.
Yeah, before we get started, later in the session, we are going to need a paper and a pencil or something to draw with. Because we're going to do a very, very short drawing activity after we read our story.
Okay, my friends. ¿Quién está listo? ¿Están listos? ¿Quién quiere empezar? Si estamos listos para empezar, vamos a tocar nuestra nariz.
If you're ready, touch your nose. If you are ready to start, touch your nose.
All right. Estamos todos listos. Okay, Edwin, start us off.
Okay, great. What's the first thing we should do? I think we should probably put on our crowns, right? So if anybody else other than Jaylene happens to have their crown, now would be a good time to put it on.
Let's see. Let's see. A ver. Listo. Esto nos lleva a la pregunta, Edwin. ¿Qué será un coquí?
What is a coquí? I think I have a little one here. Here's my coquí friend.
¿Quién me puede decir qué es un coquí? Podemos subir la mano en nuestra burbuja, en nuestra cámara. ¿Quién me puede contar qué es un coquí?
Raise your hand if you would like to tell us what a coquí is. What is a coquí?
A ver. Kailina y Darren, ¿qué es un coquí?
A coquí es una frog.
Oh, yes, a coquí is a frog. Does anyone know how to say frog in Spanish?
How do I say frog? ¿Cómo digo yo ese animal? A ver, Calvin, ¿cómo se dice? ¿Otra vez, Calvin?
Una
rana. Muy bien.
Oh, good job, Calvin.
Una rana. ¿Y dónde vive esta rana?
Where does this frog live? Who can tell us?
Let's see. ¿Dónde vive el coquí?
Where does the coquí frog live?
Delilah y Sofía.
Puerto Rico.
Puerto Rico is a beautiful island in the Caribbean Sea.
Puerto Rico es una bella isla en el mar Caribe.
So the coquí is what our coquí club is named after, but we usually also start with a song that we call the coquí song.
Exacto. Entonces, nuestro club, el nombre de nuestro club, se basa en este animalito de Puerto Rico y lo primero que hacemos cuando nos juntamos en nuestro club de coquí es cantar una canción. ¿Cómo le vamos a hacer, Edwin?
Well, first I am going to sing the coquí song in English, then we will unmute everyone and you'll get a chance to sing in English too. We will also be singing the coquí song in Spanish, but that'll be at the very, very end of the program.
Amazing. So, lo primero que vamos a hacer, Edwin nos va a cantar la canción para que sepamos cómo va, y luego nos vamos a, vamos a picar unmute todos para cantar todos juntos. Y luego, al final de nuestra sesión, volvemos a cantar en español.
Okay, I think we're ready to sing the coquí song now. So I'm going to start at the count of 1, 2, and 3. The coquí so delights me. With its song, I like going to sleep. Every night when I lie on my pillow, the coquí says good night from the tree. Coquí, 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 ki, ki, ki. Coquí, 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 ki, ki, ki. Okay, friends, now it's your turn.
A ver, vamos a quitarle el mute a nuestros micrófonos. We can all unmute now. All right.
And we're going to sing at the count of one, two, three. The cookie, so delights me. With its song, I like going to sleep. Every night when I lie on my pillow, the cookie says good night from the tree. Cookie, 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 kiki, kiki. Cookie, 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 kiki, kiki. Yay! Thank you for singing along with me, friends. You did all did such a great job.
Yes, good job, everyone.
So now we're going to read our story, right, Catalina?
Yes, we're going to read a story about who. Vamos a leer un cuento sobre nuestra amiga Frida Kahlo. ¿De qué va el cuento, Edwin?
So we're going to learn about an artist named Frida Kahlo. And Frida was a very, very famous artist. Her birthday passed not so long ago, right, Catalina? Her birthday was in July, on what date?
Vamos a hablar sobre una artista que se llamaba Frida Kahlo. Ella era de México, igual que yo. Y su cumpleaños fue el 6 de julio. Por eso este mes vamos a pensar en Frida y todo el arte muy bello que ella hizo. Y también, súper importante, queremos hablar sobre el hecho de que su vida fue muy difícil, pero no obstante de qué tan complicada era su vida, Frida siempre tenía una manera de mejorar las cosas al enfocarse en todo lo bello a su alrededor.
Yeah, Frida's birthday was actually on July 6th. And Frida was an amazing artist, but she also had some hard things that happened in her life. But the wonderful thing about Frida is she was always able to see the beauty in everything. And she put that into her artwork and in her paintings. And we're going to learn about her right now.
Absolutely. ¿Quién está listo para leer un cuento? Si estamos listos, vamos a mover nuestros dedos. ¿Listos? Ready.
Move your fingers. Wiggle your fingers if you are ready. Frida Kahlo was born in Mexico. Just by looking at her, you could see that she was special.
Frida Kahlo nació en México. Tan solo con mirarla, uno se podía dar cuenta que era especial.
When she was at school, she got very sick.
Cuando iba al colegio, se enfermó gravemente.
The illness made her leg as skinny as a rake.
La enfermedad hizo que su pierna quedara delgada como un palito.
But Frida didn't complain. She was different. She liked to dress differently too.
Pero Frida no se quejaba. Ella era diferente. También le gustaba vestirse diferente. A ver, amigos, ¿quién me puede decir dónde está Frida en esta imagen?
Where can we find Frida in this picture? Who can tell us?
¿Encuentran? Suban su manita.
If you would like to answer, raise your hand so we can unmute you.
Nora. Hi, Nora. Where in this image do you find Frida? Which one is she? Can you describe her to me?
Red.
Red?
The one in red? Maybe.
Maybe that's Frida. Someone else have a different answer?
Sí, Delilah? ¿Dónde está Frida en esta imagen?
Where can we find Frida, Delilah?
¿Qué usa? ¿Cómo? ¿De qué tipo de
She has a suit.
Oh, she's wearing a suit.
Good. Está vistiendo un traje. Muy bien.
What is Frida standing next to? For maybe it could also help people to understand which one's Frida. What is Frida standing next to?
Let's see. Kailina?
A plant?
Absolutely.
Very good. So now I think everybody can tell who Frida is.
Absolutely. ¿Qué opinas, Edwin, de que todas las niñas en la imagen traigan un vestido, un hipil, y Frida viste de traje?
Caro wants to know what I think about the fact that all of the girls seem to be wearing dresses, but Frida's clothes are different. Frida is wearing a suit. I think Frida's wearing pants, right? And I think wearing pants, you don't have to be so careful when you sit down. That's what I think.
That is right. Y a ver, amigos, vamos a ver su familia que sale en esta imagen. ¿Se ven molestos de que Frida no traiga un vestido o están contentos?
Oh. Does Frida's family look happy to be with her, even though she's wearing a suit, like same suit as the man that's next to her? Or do they seem to be okay with it? What do you guys think? I see some hands up.
Vamos a ver, I'm scrolling through my bubbles. I'm trying to call on people I haven't called on before. Also, si tu cámara está apagada, if your camera isn't on, you can raise a digital hand.
Emma, did you want to answer, Emma?
A ver, Emma.
Emma, ¿quieres responder?
¿Está feliz o triste?
¿Está feliz su familia?
Sí.
Ah, gracias, Emma.
Yes, gracias, Emma.
Emma thinks that they look very happy together.
I think so too. Yo también creo que se ven muy felices y a nadie le importa que Frida traiga un pantalón en vez de un vestido.
Yeah, I don't think anybody cares that she's wearing pants either.
Okay.
Next slide, please. After the accident, Frida had to rest in bed. To help the hours pass, she drew pictures on her foot.
Después de un accidente que Frida sufrió, tenía que quedarse en cama. Para ayudar a pasar el rato, ella hacía dibujos de su pie.
Then, even though she was still in pain, Frida decided to draw self-portraits using a mirror.
Luego, aunque sufría de mucho dolor, Frida decidió pintar autorretratos usando un espejo.
So a self-portrait is a very special kind of art. It's when somebody is drawing what? What do you think?
Un autorretrato es un tipo de arte muy especial. ¿Quién me puede explicar qué es un autorretrato? Vamos a ver. Ah, tal vez alguien que no ha hablado. Albert, do you know what a self-portrait is? You want to explain to me?
What is Frida painting? What is she making a painting of?
Albert, do you know? Do you want to explain it to me?
Can you explain? What is a self-portrait?
What is a self-portrait? It's a painting of what?
Who are you?
Painting of whom? Painting of yourself.
Good job, Albert. So it's a painting and it's a portrait, so we see a face. And then, let's see, Sofía. ¿Qué es un autorretrato?
Go ahead.
Say it again.
The girl is herself.
Yes, muy bien, Sofía.
Thank you so much for your answer. Yes, Frida is drawing herself.
Muy bien. ¿Y qué más podemos ver? ¿Qué observamos en esta imagen?
Good question. What else do we see in the picture? We see Frida painting herself, but what else do we see?
Podemos ver colores, podemos ver formas, podemos ver algún animalito.
Maybe you see colors, maybe you see shapes, maybe you see other objects in the picture. Who could tell us? Do you see an animal or an insect?
A ver, ¿qué podemos ver? ¿Quién? Kayleen, do you want to share with us something you see, a color or a shape? A ver, Kayleen. Cuenta. Go.
It's different.
Oh, it's different.
It is different, yes. Do you see, can you tell us one color that you see?
One color is red and one color is butterfly but white.
Oh, so you see many things. You see the color red and you see the color white, and butterflies are where the color white is, right? Very good, Jaylene.
Oh, muy bien, Jaylene. Hay mucho rojo y también hay una parte blanca y hay muchas maripositas. Última pregunta. ¿Por qué hay dos Fridas en esta imagen?
That's such a good question. Why are there two Fridas in this picture? Why do I see Frida two times?
Why could that be? Oh, I saw a cat. A cat scared me. I was scrolling through the bubbles and a cat walked over.
Oh, I'm sorry I missed that. I love cats.
The cat scared me. Okay, let's see. ¿Por qué hay dos Fridas en esta imagen? Nora, do you have an idea? Would you like to share, Nora? Why are there two Fridas? You want to share maybe later? Okay. Let's see. Delilah, go ahead.
But she has a mirror and she wanted to paint herself because her leg was in pain.
Oh, very nice.
So here we have a great example of what a self-portrait is. Un gran ejemplo de lo que es un autorretrato. Okay, vamos a ver qué va a pasar en la historia.
Okay, let's continue with the story. Painting by painting, Frida and her art got better. It was time to show her pictures to someone else.
Pintura por pintura, Frida y su arte fueron mejorando. Era hora de mostrarle sus pinturas a alguien más.
She visited the famous artist, Diego Rivera, who couldn't believe his eyes. He wasn't sure what he liked more, her pictures or her.
Visitó al prestigioso pintor Diego Rivera, quien no podía creer lo que veía. No estaba seguro qué le gustaba más, sus pinturas o Frida.
Frida and Diego fell in love. They were so similar and yet so different. But through their ups and downs, Diego encouraged Frida in her paintings.
Frida y Diego se enamoraron. Eran tan parecidos y a la vez tan diferentes. Pero a pesar de todo, Diego siempre apoyó a Frida y sus pinturas.
Through her wonderful pictures, Frida spoke about how she was feeling. In some, she looked sad, but in others, she smiled.
A través de sus maravillosas pinturas, Frida hablaba sobre sus sentimientos. En algunas pinturas, lucía triste y en otras, sonreía.
Eventually, Frida decided to show everyone her work. Her pictures caused a great stir in New York City.
Finalmente, Frida decidió presentar su obra al público. Sus pinturas causaron un gran alboroto en Nueva York.
When the exhibition came to Mexico, Frida was so sick she had to be in bed. But it was clear that nothing could stop her from painting. Not sickness, not pain, or heartache.
Cuando la exposición llegó a México, ella estaba tan enferma que tenía que estar en cama. Pero era obvio que nada podría impedir que Frida pintara, ni enfermedades, dolor o tristeza.
Frida sure loved painting.
Yeah, Frida amaba pintar.
Frida Kahlo taught the world to wave goodbye to bad things and say, viva la vida, live life.
Frida Kahlo le enseñó al mundo a despedirse de lo malo y decir, viva la vida. Tan, tan.
The end. Now, friends, remember in the beginning, we asked you to get a paper and something to draw with, maybe a pencil or a crayon, whatever you happen to have. Now we're going to do our 1 minute drawing exercise. So what we would like you to do is find something in your room that's close by and you can draw that. So maybe you have a stuffed animal, maybe you have a brother or sister, a sibling that's right next to you and you wanna draw them. Maybe there's a vase, maybe it's a box of cereal.
Sí, exactamente. Vamos a hacer una pequeña actividad, vamos a hacer un pequeño dibujo y Frida nos enseñó que a veces estamos atrapados en nuestra casa, como ahorita, pero hay muchas cosas que podemos pintar y dibujar. Entonces, vamos a encontrar algo que tengamos a nuestro alrededor. Voy a ver. Puede ser un juguete, puede ser nuestra taza del desayuno, puede ser una plantita. Vamos a ver, ¿qué puedo encontrar yo? Ah, ya encontré una taza con una flor. Vamos a encontrar algo que podemos dibujar.
Yes, we're going to be inspired by Frida drawing things from around our house. Because we can always make art when we're home, right? Frida had to stay home a lot, just like many of us now, and she was able to work from what was around her. I think I am going to grab my coffee cup, kind of like Carolina, except mine does not have flowers in it.
Okay, vamos a hacer un pequeño dibujo en nuestro papel con nuestro plumón. Vamos a hacer un dibujo de nuestro objeto. Un minutito. A ver, ¿quién está dibujando? Puedo ver a Emma dibujar. Estoy viendo a Sofía y Delilah, Darren y Kailina. Creo que Calvin está dibujando.
Wow, so great that so many people are drawing.
A ver, un minutito más. Edwin, ¿tú estás dibujando?
Of course, claro que estoy dibujando. Me encanta dibujar. I love to draw. Of course I'm drawing.
A ver. Esto es lo que llamamos un bosquejo. Es un dibujo rapidito.
Yes, we're doing a very quick sketch. It's a very fast drawing that we do.
No tiene que ser perfecto. Okay. If you're done, you can hold your drawing into the camera. Si estamos listos, podemos mostrar nuestra imagen en la cámara. Wow, Sofía, muy bien. Emma, muy bien.
Oh, very nice.
Delilah, muy bien. Nora,
oh, good job, Calvin.
Muy bien.
Hi, Kalina. Thank you for sharing your drawing.
Okay. So, ¿por qué hicimos un bosquejo ahorita? Es la pregunta. Y la razón es que cuando hacemos una pintura, como los hacía Frida, Muchas veces, por lo general, hacemos un bosquejo antes para poder orientarnos y saber qué vamos a dibujar. Entonces, yo empecé con una taza con unas plantas. Luego hice un bosquejo y luego, después de eso, puedo hacer una pintura. Aquí tengo mi taza y mis flores.
So we can ask ourselves, why did we do a drawing today? We don't usually do drawings in Cookie Club, but we are being inspired by Frida Kahlo, who's a painter. And oftentimes when somebody's doing a painting, before they get started with the paint, they will do a drawing or a sketch. Like, see Carolina's, and you can see mine. Carolina went a step further, right? Carolina was able to do like Frida and turn hers into a painting. So for our takeaway activity today, when we will be contacting your parents with the email that has the information that we like to send for you every week, this time our activity is going to be for us to continue our sketch and turn it into a painting. Or if you'd like, you could create a new drawing and turn that into a painting.
Definitivamente. Como cada sesión en Coqui, vamos a mandarles una actividad. Unas instrucciones para la actividad. Y la actividad de esta semana es hacer una pintura así como pintaba Frida. Es por eso que hicimos nuestro bosquejo, para luego hacer una pintura en un formato un poco más grande y para usar pintura. Y también porque es una buena actividad para hacer con nuestro adulto o con nuestros hermanitos. Okay.
What's going to happen next, Carolina?
Ahí están unas imágenes con instrucciones, los tres pasos, escoger una imagen, hacer el boceto, y luego hacer la pintura.
So in this slide, we can see a closer image of Carolina's still life, the mug that she showed us with the flower. And then next we see the drawing that Carolina created. And then at the very end, the last one, we see that she took that drawing and she made a painting based on the drawing.
Absolutamente. Bueno, y con esto casi termina nuestra sesión. Vamos a cantar una vez más la canción del Coqui en español. Pero antes de cantar, les queremos dar las gracias. ¿Y qué les queremos decir, Edwin?
Oh, so we're about to sing the Coqui song one more time, led by Carolina, but this time in Spanish. So we wanted to thank everyone for joining us today here at Coqui Club. We also wanted to remind you to visit our website, edmuseo.org, to find out about other programs that we have available for you. This program was part of El Museo en Tu Casa. We want to invite you, if you've done your art activities and want to share it with people on social media, you can do that on hashtag Edmuseo en tu casa or hashtag Coqui Club. Also, we'd like to remind you that Edmuseo is letting the community know to fill out the census this year. It only happens once every 10 years. It's very important that we do that so that our communities can be counted when they're giving support and monies to different neighborhoods in the city.
Sí. Entonces, como Edwin acaba de decir, para saber de todos los cursos que estamos dando en línea, pueden visitar nuestra página que es elmuseo.org. También nos pueden seguir en Instagram y cuando hagan sus actividades relacionadas a nuestras clasecitas, pueden subirlas a Instagram, a los medios sociales y usar el hashtag El Museo en Tu Casa. También queremos recordarles que este año el museo está trabajando en recordar a toda la gente que vive en Nueva York de llenar el censo habitacional. Es súper importante, solo pasa uno de cada 10 años y es importante porque es el momento en el que podemos decir cuánta gente hay, de dónde somos, qué nacionalidades vivimos en esta ciudad. Entonces, es súper importante participar. Ahora, ¿estamos listos para cantar?
I'm ready. You guys ready to sing the cookie song in Spanish with Carolina?
Si estamos listos, ¿qué hacemos? Movemos nuestros hombros. ¿Quién está listo para cantar? Ok. Vamos a cantar todos juntos, así que vamos a quitarle el mute a nuestros micrófonos. Let's all unmute.
Oh, we're going to sing together. How exciting.
Let's see. Okay, I'm seeing that a few friends are unmuting. Let's all unmute. All right, are we ready?
Yes.
Okay, so we're going to sing en español. ¿Estamos listos?
Everyone ready?
Vamos a empezar.
Sí.
Dos y tres.
El coqui siempre canta. Es lindo cantar el coqui. Por las noches a veces me duermo. Con el dulce cantar del coqui. Coqui, coqui. Coqui, 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 coqui. Good job, everyone.
Gracias.
Gracias. Gracias. Gracias. Gracias. Gracias. Gracias. Gracias.